number 6 of your grammar book. In my previous video, I already taught you two parts of this exercise. Those who have done will continue after that, but those who have not done, for your convenience, I'll teach you all the parts of this exercise. So pause the video, go and bring your grammar book. Yes, now open page number 6. I'm reading the question for you. The highlighted words in these sentences have more than one meaning. Use a dictionary to find their meanings as they are used in the sentences. So here question, you will not write this, you will write down the question. Write down the meaning of the underlined words. So open your reader notebook of 4 lines. Put the heading grammar and chapter 1, the alphabetical order. Now start writing along with me. First you will write down the question. What is the question? Write down. Those who have earlier done two parts will continue after that on the same page. Write down the meaning of the underlined words. Here you will not highlight the word, you will underline the word. In this way you will write. Now first sentence I am writing for you. The first sentence is, the dog's bark could be heard from a long distance. Those who have done this first and second part will not do, will continue after this. The third part, from third part you will continue. So the question is, the dog's bark could be heard. The dog's bark could be heard from a long distance. Yes, students, here the underlined word is bark. Now, here you have to write down the meaning of this underlined word. Now, this, read the sentence carefully once again. The dog's bark could be heard from a long distance. Means the sound of dog, the cry of dog, you can hear, it can be heard from a long distance. So, write down the meaning of this bark. Here, bark, its meaning is cry of a dog. Cry of a dog. In this way you will do. Now second part, these two parts we have already done. Second part, the woodpecker makes a hole. Need not to do again. Those who have done will continue from third part. Those who have not done will continue from the beginning. The woodpecker makes a hole. The woodpecker makes a hole in the bark for its nest. Makes a hole in the bark for its nest. Have you seen woodpecker bird? It has a long beak and it makes a hole in the outermost layer of the tree to make its nest. Now here also see, bark word is used, but here the meaning of bark is different. Here the meaning of bark is in first sentence cry of a dog. Now in second sentence, here bark means the outermost layer of the tree. Where does woodpecker makes nest? On the outermost layer of the tree, of the stem. So write down its meaning. Outermost or uppermost, anything you can write. Outermost layer of the stem. You can also write uppermost also. I think in previous video we have going to rub the first part. You can pause your video here if you have not written along with me, and you can complete your work. Now I am going to rub the first one. Third sentence. He can draw beautiful sceneries. Write down the sentence. He can draw beautiful sceneries. Now here underlined word is draw. What is the meaning of draw, children? You also draw picture in your drawing book? In your science notebook you draw diagram. So here draw means to draw a figure, to make a picture by making lines. So write down its meaning. Meaning of draw is produce a picture by making lines. Write down, children. Now second one I am going to rub. Pencil only. So here the highlighted word or the underlined word is present. The boy was present on the day of assessment. Now, here present means the boy was present, means he was available on the day of assessment. So, its meaning is available. A-V-A-I-L, available. A-V-L-E-able, available. Now, next student, I am going to write fourth one. And writing sixth part here. You have to complete all exercise today. Now, sixth part, and your this chapter will also be completed now. Yes, Prithvi gave me a lovely present for my birthday. Write down. Prithvi gave me a lovely present for my birthday. Now here also present word is used. Now children, what is the meaning of present here? You all know that because you also get present on your birthday. So it is, meaning of present is here gift. You receive also present and you give also present to others. Now next, seventh must. We must make a key to explain the map. Write down the sentence. We must make a key to explain the map. Now here, meaning of highlighted word is here, you will underline the word key. Now what is the meaning of key here? Children, when you draw maps and you have to show mountains, rivers, forests, so what do? You make a symbol to show all these areas in the map. Because on map you don't have to write, you only can make symbols to show all these areas. So here key means a list of symbols. A list of symbols. Now children, write it down. Now eighth part I am going to write here. Closing. When you go out of the house, you lock the door, and when you come back, you open it by closing a lock. Key is used for opening or closing a lock. Next, children, we are going to write ninth part. Ninth part is, he left his city to find a new job. He left his city to find a new job. Here, children, underline word is, you will underline left. He left his city to find a new job. Now, what is the meaning of left here? To leave the place. Left meaning is to leave the place. And this is also past participle form of leave. So, meaning is to leave. To leave the place. Next, children, 10th part we are going to write. Don't be in hurry, write very slowly in good, even clean handwriting. Now, 10th part we are going to write. 10th part is, Aaron is more comfortable using his left hand. Aaron is more comfortable using his left hand. Now here underlined word is again left. Now here what is the meaning of left? Everybody has understood, I think everybody knows it. That is the opposite of right hand. Opposite of right hand is your left hand. Right hand you use for eating, you use for writing. So the opposite of right hand is left hand. Opposite of right hand. Now children, write down this. Now 8th I'm going to rub to write down the next part. Total 12 parts are there. I'm going to write 11th part. 11th is, I went to deposit the money in the bank. I went to deposit the money in the bank. Where do you deposit money? To keep it safe. Everybody deposits in bank. So here, bank, its meaning is, underline the word bank. Its meaning is, what is the meaning of bank, children? Everybody knows. Can you tell the meaning? Bank, it's an organization. An organization what is it? An organization that holds, what does it hold? Money. And it also holds valuable things. If you want to keep it safe, you keep it in the locker provided by the bank. Next is 12th part and last sentence. Tina sat on the river bank. Tina See, there is difference between the meaning of bank in both the sentences. It is used in different way. So the here the meaning of bank is, what is river bank? The land alongside a body of water. So here, what is the body of water? That is river. So the land alongside river. Land alongside means both the sides. Land alongside river. It is called river bank. Now I am rubbing the last one so that you may not confuse children. So this is your work. Now total 12 sentences are there. All these 12 sentences you will write down in your notebook. I have written the sentence also, its meaning also, so that you